During those wonderful years when I was out in the rainforest at Gombe, I learned about the interrelationship of all plant and animal life, making up this complex tapestry of life, this web of life that we call biodiversity. I realized how each species, no matter how small, had a role to play, and how the extinction of even a small and seemingly insignificant species can have a ripple effect that can and actually has led to ecosystem collapse. It's a shocking fact that we're in the midst of the sixth great extinction of plant and animal life, and we face the threat also of climate change. This is affecting ecosystems around the world and playing an increasingly major role in the loss of biodiversity. It's really clear that we urgently need to take action. First, we need to understand that we humans are part of the natural world, and we depend on it for clean air, water, food, everything. But what we depend on is healthy ecosystems. Therefore, it's clearly of huge importance that we work hard to protect existing intact areas of the natural world and attempt to restore damaged ecosystems. It is our disrespect of the natural world that's led to climate change and biodiversity loss. We can't expect to have unlimited global economic development on a planet with finite natural resources, which in some places we're using up faster than nature can replenish them. It's all about GDP. Fortunately, there are many organizations today working on creating a more sustainable relationship with the natural world. And I think more people understand this because of the pandemic we're suffering from, which was also brought about by our disrespect of animals and their habitats. Fortunately, nature is amazingly resilient if we give her a chance. Places that have been utterly destroyed, such as an abandoned quarry or a terribly polluted river or lake, can, with time and perhaps some help, once again begin building up the diversity that's needed to make up that so important healthy ecosystem. At one time, the Gombe National Park, a very tiny national park, where for 30 years I and my team have been studying the chimpanzees, once it was part of the great forest belt that stretched across equatorial Africa. That was the case when I began in 1960. But by the late 80s, Gombe was an isolated patch of forest surrounded by totally bare hills. There were more people living there than the land could support. Their farmland was overused and infertile, and they were too poor to buy food from elsewhere. So they cut down trees to find new soil for growing crops to feed their growing population, or for charcoal to get some money. What else could they do? So in 1994, the Jane Goodall Institute began working with these villagers, helping them find ways of living without destroying their environment. Together, JGI and the villagers, we designed a holistic program, Take Care or Takari, and that's JGI's method of community-based conservation. It includes restoring fertility to the soil without chemical fertilizers, pesticides, herbicides, and so on. Water management programs, scholarships for girls to have a chance of higher education, microcredit programs for villagers, mostly women, to start their own small environmentally sustainable businesses. We also provide family planning information and environmental education through our Roots and Shoots program. From now 104 villages throughout the chimpanzee range, there are volunteers who learn how to use smartphones, and they monitor the health of their village forest reserves where most of Gombe's chimps live, most of Tanzania's chimps live. Well, today there are no more bare hills. Trees and other vegetation have grown from seeds that were lying dormant under the soil, sometimes from the roots of trees that once grew there. Areas of land around the park are being set aside by the villagers as a buffer zone between the chimpanzees and the villagers. And along with the vegetation, animal species have recolonized the area, moving out from the park and providing the biodiversity that is so important to the people as well as wildlife. Land has also been set aside by the villagers to allow the isolated chimps of Gombe to once again have interaction with other remnant groups, thus preventing the danger of inbreeding. Our Roots and Shoots program for youth requires members to choose one project to benefit the environment and wildlife and informs them about the importance of biodiversity, encouraging them to take action, action, action. You know, there's some wonderful projects going on around the world. I'm really encouraged by the growing number of rewilding programs that are becoming very successful in some countries. There's some of these programs in the United States. Huge areas have been set aside in Europe as a result of cooperation between different countries, and some animal species that have been extinct for years have been successfully reintroduced. It's so important to share these success stories. It gives people hope that we can turn things around before it's too late, but we must take action, all of us. Please help. Thank you.